Hello guys, this is Revan from Digi Integrity. Welcome to Tech News episode 91. With just hours to go before the new IT rules for social media companies take effect, large digital platform Facebook and Google on Tuesday asserted they are working towards a meeting of compliance requirements. The new rules announced on Feb 25th require large social media platforms like Twitter, Facebook, Instagram and WhatsApp to follow additional due diligence, including the appointment of Chief Compliance Officer, Nodal Contact Person and Resident Grievance Officer. Arogya Setu will now show the blue ticks and the shield on the home screen of the application. Those who have received both doses of either vaccine will now see two blue ticks and a shield on their profile under the Your Status section. People who have only received one dose on the other hand will see a partial vaccinated status. The city of Dubai has launched its own cryptocurrency. The cryptocurrency is called Dubai Coin Dbx and it is based on a public blockchain system. This means that the blockchain ledger behind the currency will be maintained by the public and the new coins can be created by mining them. Dbx will likely be available on selected exchanges for now, but big exchanges tend to pick up coins that do well eventually. The coin's price have surged by over 1000% over the past 24 hours. According to crypto.com, it was launched at the price of $0.17 and was trading at $1.13 at the time of writing. Nubia launches its latest gaming smartphone called Red Magic 6R. It's not a huge upgrade over the Red Magic 6 and Red Magic 6 Pro, but comes with a much slimmer body and more universally appealing design, dropping some of the gaming aesthetics. The Nubia Red Magic 6R is powered by a Snapdragon 888 chipset, could be coupled with either 8GB or 12GB of RAM. The display is a 6.67 inch AMOLED display with a 144Hz refresh rate and a single punch hole in the center. The Renault 6 series from Oppo continues to grow in numbers and the latest addition are the Renault 6, Renault 6 Pro and Renault 6 Pro Plus. The two Pro variants will feature identical specifications save for the cameras and chipset, with the Pro utilizing the Dimensity 1200 processor while the Pro Plus is outfitted with the Snapdragon 870 instead. The vanilla version opt for the recently announced Dimensity 900 and all three phones comes with a triple camera setup and a 65W SuperVOOC 2.0 charging. The first sale of Renault 6 in China are scheduled for June 11th, while the Renault 6 Pro and 6 Pro Plus are scheduled for June 5th. If you were hoping to bag a PlayStation 5, we have a bad news. The console was restocked in India and opened up for pre-orders, but they are all sold out now. Retailers like Amazon, Flipkart, Chroma, Prepaid Gamer Card, Vijay Sales, Games The Shop, Reliance Digital, etc. have all opened up pre-orders at noon today, and it was a matter of minutes they were all sold out. Flipkart and Sony Center say that they will be start delivering by June 7th. Amazon has given an approximate delivery date between June 8th and June 11th. And if you have not, we feel you and better luck next time. OnePlus via OnePlus.in microsite has confirmed the launch event on June 10th and it also confirmed the sale dates for the OnePlus Note CE 5G as well as OnePlus TV U1S smart TVs. The OnePlus TV U1S smart TVs will go on sale on the launch day itself, but the sale will be only for the Red Cable Club members. These TVs will go on open sale starting June 11th. The same day OnePlus Note CE 5G will go on sale for the first time for the Red Cable Club members. OnePlus Note CE 5G will be open sale starting on June 16th in the country for Europe and India. IQ India's official Twitter handle has teased the launch of the IQ Z series. IQ Z3 5G launch date in India is yet to be revealed. IQ Z3 5G price in India could be around ₹25,000. Transition Group smartphone brand Itel has officially launched its latest new smartphone, the Itel A23 Pro, in partnership with Reliance Jio. Last month, we saw a report which detailed that Itel is readying with Reliance Jio to introduce a low-cost 4G smartphone in India. Now, without any ado, Itel has introduced the A23 Pro, its cheapest 4G smartphone officially in India, that cost ₹3,899. With this new smartphone launch, Reliance Jio users will also be entitled to get benefits of worth ₹3,000. The benefit worth ₹3,000 include vouchers from partner on selected prepaid recharge of ₹249 and above. The IKEA shopping app has been launched in India. The Swedish home furnishing company has been launched its app for both Android and iOS users, and the same will act as a dedicated e-commerce platform for all of the IKEA products. The IKEA shopping app will make for a direct single brand gateway to over 7,000 IKEA home furnishing products, the company said in a statement. However, while the IKEA shopping app can be downloaded anywhere in India by anyone, the company will still ship its product to a limited number of cities. At this moment, the cities are eligible for delivery include Ahmedabad, Hyderabad, Mumbai, Pune, Surat and Vadodara. The latest IDC prediction on the smartphone is painting an optimistic picture. Based on the gathered data, IDC is forecasting 1.38 billion smartphone shipments for 2021, which would be a 7.7% increase comparing to last year and the highest total since 2015. The upward trend is also expected to continue into 2022, but with a more modest 3.8% of annual growth. A new report has revealed that the global smartwatch market has seen a notable growth of 35% year-on-year in the first quarter of this year. Apple led the market and even saw a whopping 50% growth year-on-year as well. According to the reports, the Cupertino-based giant led the market thanks to the robust demand for its latest 6 series models. The iPhone maker's overall market share also rose by 3%. The Samsung shipments also rose by 27% year-on-year with its Galaxy Watch 3 and Galaxy Watch Active series being in demand. However, the South Korean smartphone maker's growth was below the overall market average and it even saw a slight decline in its market share. Realme C25s will reportedly launch in India sometime in June. Realme C25 is set to come with a 64GB and 128GB storage variants, both with 4GB of RAM. This handset originally launched in Malaysia. The upcoming Sony WF-1000XM4 True Wireless handset will have an active noise cancellation. Not surprising considered to the current XM3 model has it too. The interesting part there is that this feature will be enabled by a custom chip called Sony V1. This won't be Sony's first custom chip, of course, but comparing to QN1E found inside the current XM3 buds, this one will add support for high quality wireless audio transmitted using LDAC. The buds will also have a high resolution audio certified. Jeff Bezos will formally step down as Amazon CEO on July 5th. He announced it Wednesday at the company's annual shareholder meetings. Andy Jassy, Amazon cloud computing boss, will take over Bezos' role. Once he steps down, Bezos will translate to executive chairman of Amazon's board. North Korean leader Kim Jong-un has recently put a ban to wearing skinny jeans, sporting mullet hairstyle and somebody piercing, keeping in line with the country's crackdown on capitalistic lifestyle and Western influences on youth. The state-run newspaper had recently warned the nation of doing more to stop capitalistic culture from seeping into the country. The agency said that leader Kim Jong-un has also outlawed non-socialistic hairstyle such as spike and mullet along with the dyed hair. As part of the new laws, men and women can only sport one of the 215 other hairstyle authorized. The Provisional Youth League has also issued an order on hairstyles it deems proper sport. Hairstyles such as mullets and spikes have been considered as antisocial. Ripped or skinny jeans, t-shirts sporting slogans and nose and lip piercing have been also banned. Officials in North Korea also cracking down on pop music after the popularity of South Korean K-pop bands such as BTS and Blackpink. Xiaomi published its financial report on the 3 months period that ends on March 31, 2021, which shows growth across the board. The total revenue for the company is 76.9 billion yuan, up to 54.7% compared of the same period last year, while the adjusted net profit went up to yuan 6.1 billion, a 163.8% increase over last year. Xiaomi Mi Pad 5 tipped to feature a 120Hz display side-mounted fingerprint sensor, and Mi Pad 5 is said to be powered by a Qualcomm Snapdragon 870 processor. Xiaomi partner Segway Ninebot has unveiled 2 new electric scooters under the Kick Scooter F series. The Ninebot Kick Scooter F series is a feature-rich yet cost-effective mobility tool that has an extended range of 25 miles, a top speed of 18.6 miles per hour max, a foldable design and a Bluetooth anti-theft security lock. The series is made up of a Kick Scooter F30 and a Kick Scooter F40. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.